Hey everyone, this is Mark. Happy Thursday to you. Welcome to my channel and welcome to another video. So today, in keeping with the Camden album review series, we're gonna look at Come On Everybody by Elvis. This actually is one of my favorite Camden releases. It was released, I believe, in 1971. But a very cool cover. I've always liked this cover. This was, of course, taken during the Vegas International Hotel in 1970, during That's the Way It Is. But a very cool cover, nonetheless. And there's the back of it. That's kind of generic, different. But this is a first pressing. Now, with some of these were on the RCA Camden label, also referred to as a budget label. So I did get this brand new probably about 2 years ago, and got it for a really, really decent price. I have seen them go for probably more than what people should pay for them, because if it is a first press, it should be on the blue Camden label. It was also released later, I believe, beginning in 1975. Pickwick bought the rights, I guess, to press these. I was not a huge fan of the Pickwick, to be honest with you. I thought they were kind of cheaply made. As a kid, that's pretty much all I had, with the exception of Elvis sings "Burning Love" and "Hits from His Movies." I had gotten that. That was my first Elvis album I ever got. That was on the blue RCA Camden label. But everything I had after, I did not have this one as a kid, actually. I had Flaming Star. I also had, I'm trying to think what else I had. I had Separate Ways. And I had, which is my least favorite of the Camdens, but I did have it, Elvis Sings Hits from His Movies, which came out in 1972. So, yeah, this one was not one that I had. What I was going to say about this particular thing, I said that to come to this. Sometimes you got a paper inner sleeve, sometimes you didn't. It was kind of like throwing the dice. You either got a paper sleeve or you didn't. You think that they would pack these with a paper sleeve to kind of protect the album better, but again, thus the budget label. So, I will show you this. The actual vinyl. So this was one of the ones, if I remember right. Yes, it did not come in any type of paper sleeve. So I will take this out very carefully. Put that aside. So there you have it. And this, I believe, was on the Dynaflex, which by this year, 1971, they were making them on the... Ooh. And that's the problem when it's just cardboard. What I really need to do is package it, get a sleeve for it, package it outside the album. But there is side one. And then... And there is side two. So what I want to do, what I always like to do is... I like to put this on the turntable so you can kind of get a listen for it, to hear what it sounds like. I think they sound pretty darn good. That's my opinion, but I'm gonna pause this, put it on the turntable, and I'll be right back with you. All right, welcome back. This is the...
Show me a girl with a dimple on her cheek, but her mouth's in her mouth when she opens it to speak. Show me a girl who is acting so refined, and I'll show you a girl with one thing on her mind.
This is my favorite song on the album, I think.
So I say, you know what? She says, what? I say, what? Oh, I'm not the marrying kind.
And I notice it's kind of weird. Usually, on these Camden albums, these songs usually are taken from movies. It tells you what movie it comes from. But none of these say,
I will be my free what? She said, what? I say, what?
Follow that dream. Nothing.
No. You know what? She says, what? I say, what? Thanks a lot. But I'm not the married kind. Don't kiss me, don't claw me, don't pet me, don't paw me.
As far as how they sound, I think they sound good for budget records. I think they sound really, really good. Strong bass. Elvis's vocals come out nice and clear. And I think a very nice grouping. And that's what I really like about a lot of these albums. Like, Take Almost in Love. That was my first one that I did as far as a Camden review. I did that. If you check back in my library, you'll see it. That is my favorite Camden album. And the songs that they pieced together, mostly from Live a Little, Love a Little, they just fit good. They fit good on the album. I like this last song too. Pretty cool song. So yeah, that's what I really like about these albums. A lot of them have like their own flavor, their own style. Almost in Love, or not Almost in Love, Let's Be Friends is another one. A lot of songs from Chara, or not a lot of songs, a lot of songs from Change of Habit, the one song from Charo, so that's another good one. That was actually towards the bottom for me, but it's really grown on me in the last year. So what songs are on this fantastic release? So we got Come On Everybody, Angel, Easy Come Easy Go, A Whistling Tune, Follow That Dream, and then Side 2, King of the Whole Wide World, I'll Take Love, Today, Tomorrow, and Forever, I'm Not the Marrying Kind, which is what you're listening to now, and This Is Living. So yeah, there you have it. So yeah, like I said, I got this brand new sealed roughly about 2 years ago. I was very happy to add it. Like I said, no inner sleeve whatsoever. I think about half of them I have to. All right, so that's the final song. So I will take that off there. So yeah, that is my review and listen and look at Come On Everybody. Like I said, this is my second favorite album of the series. They were made beginning in 1969. The first one was Flaming Star. That was actually a Singer Presents from Singer Sewing Machine Company that also sponsored the Elvis 68 special. They released that album. If you went into the store, into the Singer Sewing Machine store, you could buy the album. And if you bought the album, you got a free bonus photo. So I'm hoping that could be my next Camden release review. I had the album. I got it brand new. It was sealed. Never played it yet. I'll play it when I do the review. But a good friend that I met through the Elvis community, through Facebook and through this channel, actually had the bonus photo, and he is sending it to me. And I should have it either today or tomorrow. Last I checked, it looks like it's going to arrive tomorrow. So if it's not the next Camden review I do, it may be the one after that, but depending on how mail times go. But very excited to add that. I always had the album, but I did have the bonus photo, and just so happened to strike up a conversation with this gentleman, and he was kind enough to sell it to me. And he sold it to me for peanuts, I'll tell you that. It was mainly just the cost of shipping. So very pleased to get that. So yeah, Come On Everybody, 1971 RCA Camden release. And if you, a lot of times if you get these, unfortunately, because everything Elvis in the Elvis market is going up considerably, I think I did see a sealed RCA Camden copy. And I want to say it was listed at $65, which I paid a fraction of that when I got it a couple of years ago. The Pickwick label, I do not own the Pickwick copy. But you can get that really cheap. You can get that usually for 10 to 15 bucks, brand new. So there you have it. Once again, thank you as always for watching and for supporting my channel. If you like the content, please consider liking and subscribing to help the channel grow. I really appreciate it. So until next time, you all stay safe out there and take care. We'll see you soon. Bye.